because there was nothing available to print for people to, you know, actually see how stuff works and complex mechanical assemblies available. So I shared the first engine that's down here, and it got really popular, and then I just kind of went with it and got carried away. So I'm a mechanical engineer by schooling and some work, but what I have here is a 3D printed engine assembly, and it allows you to see all the working innards of the transmission and engine, all the moving cams and camshafts, gears, everything. I designed it while I was rebuilding the actual engine, because there was nothing available to print for people to, you know, actually see how stuff works and complex mechanical assemblies available. So I shared the first engine that's down here, and it got really popular, and then I just kind of went with it and got carried away.
Awesome. So is this a full-time endeavor or a part-time endeavor?
Yeah, right now it just started being a full-time endeavor. I try and make all my files open source so people can download them and print their own. I sell hardware kits, so that's what I'm trying to focus on, is produce more models, more hardware kits, but still keep the idea open source so people can learn about printing or about engines and mechanics. So the biggest learning was probably gearing on the transmission, but that was so long ago that the learning curve was very steep, but once I got that figured out, it's just pretty much smooth sailing from there. But also being a way to visualize all the moving parts is also tricky. Having cutaways in the right sections, being able to see the moving parts, because I wanted to maintain the visual look of the real thing without, you know, making it cartoony or toy looking. So that's one of the challenges on all the engines.
Excellent. Could you actually demonstrate? Is this working?
Yeah, so this is working. So this is a 5-speed from a Toyota 4-wheel drive pickup. That's neutral. So that's first gear, and then that's second, and then that's third gear, and then fourth gear, and that's fifth, and reverse. And so this is a 4-wheel drive. So it also has a transfer case. So it's a 4-wheel drive right now. That's 2-wheel. That's four, and then that's 4-wheel drive low. And then back in 4-wheel drive high. So.
What has been your favorite part of doing this project?
I love the CAD part, sitting down and designing it and being able to see it before I print it. But being able to take the design and go to the printer and have something that's tangible in my hands within a day and seeing it work after being designed is very cool.
I see the 3D printer over there. Is that the actual 3D printer you use?
I try and print on the cheapest printer I can find. So that's a sub $200 printer. It's a kit. You build it yourself. If my printer can print it, anybody's printer can print it, as long as it's big enough. So everything here is printed on that machine, and everything comes out as you see it here.
Do you have any recommendations for somebody that wants to get into this or wants to recreate it using your files?
Yeah, if somebody wants to print one of my engines, the easiest one is probably the Toyota 4-cylinder. It has the least amount of moving parts. So, and it's the smallest if you have a limited size on the printer. It's also the least amount of print time. So it's about 100 to 120 hours of print time total for all the pieces. So it's not, I mean, compared to the other ones, the V8s are about 200-hour print time. The transmissions are probably about 200 also. So it's a good amount of, it's a commitment, but, you know, it's a good learning experience. So.